We have seen incandescent bulbs, which is one of the oldest types of bulbs. Then came the CFL lamps and bulbs, which is more efficient than incandescent bulbs. But now we are in the era of LED lights, which has better efficiency than other two types, and that is why they're very popular. LEDs basically contain two specialized semiconductors that are stuck together. And when we apply a large enough voltage across them, they emit light from a process called electroluminescence. LEDs can last for 10 years and its efficiency is superior to any other kind of light source. That is why we come across LED flashlights, LED street lights, LED boards, and so many other applications. So, let's learn a bit about this fascinating LED's construction and working principle. LEDs are just a PN junction diode with some special properties added during the doping process. As in the case of normal PN diode, when we apply some voltage across the LED, the electrons from N-type semiconductor and holes from P-type semiconductor will interact. They recombine with each other at a region called depletion region. During this recombination process, some energy will come out in the form of photons which radiate light. This junction is enclosed in hard plastic shell which also acts as a lens to focus the light. Now, coming to the working part. Every LED will have its own forward voltage, the voltage at which it starts glowing. For a white light LED, it will be around 3.2 volts. So, you get different colored LEDs based on their forward voltage. In the case of white LEDs, when you supply 3.2 volts, the current will flow in the LED and it glows. Anything less, it won't. The LEDs should be properly connected with its positive and negative ends, because it only conducts current in one direction. LEDs have anode and cathode leads which we use to connect them in the circuit. Anode will be positive end and cathode will be negative end. We can get to know the anode and cathode leads by looking at the length of the leads. Anode lead will be longer than the cathode lead in the LEDs. The current flowing through the LEDs should be controlled, because they have the limit on maximum current that can flow through them. If the current exceeds this maximum current, the LEDs will burn out. Most of the times, we use resistors in the circuit with LEDs to limit the current. This is all about LEDs, an efficient light source. To sum up, we learnt about advantages of LED over incandescent and CFL, construction of LEDs using special semiconductors, working of LEDs where it emits photons that radiate light. In the next video, we learn about another type of diode called photodiode. But before you go, a small activity here for you. Make a mini traffic light or a light display board with 5 to 10 LEDs and resistor circuit. Through this, you will get to know about LEDs even better.